Hello, 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 and thank you for tuning on to another episode of our Scripture Breakdown Ministry. My name is David Abraham, and our scripture for today comes from Isaiah 54, verse 4, and it reads, "Do not fear, for you will not be ashamed, neither be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame. For you will forget the shame of your youth, and will not remember the reproach of your widowhood anymore." I repeat, do not fear, for you will not be ashamed, neither be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame. For you will forget the shame of your youth, and will not remember the reproach of your widowhood anymore. Now, I want to divide the scripture into four parts. And the first part says, do not fear, for you will not be ashamed. Now, first and foremost, I'd like to say that Isaiah 54 speaks about a barren woman, speaks about a barren woman that could be transcended into a barren land. A barren woman, first and foremost, he said, do not fear, for you will not be ashamed. So God is telling this barren woman that she should not fear. He said, do not fear, that you will not be ashamed. You will not be ashamed for the fact that you are barren. You will not be ashamed for the fact that you have not bore child. You will not be ashamed for the fact that you haven't proved yourself as a woman. That in the context of reproduction, do not be ashamed. Then it says, neither be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame. So God is saying to the barren woman that you will not be disgraced, you will not be put to shame, that shame will be wiped out, that instead of that shame, you will have double honor, that he will take away that shame, he will take away that reproach, he will take away that disdain that people treat you with because you are barren. And the third bit says, for you will forget the shame of your youth. Now she is barren in her youthfulness. She's barren in a situation where she's barren in a situation where she is young. So for you will forget the shame of your youth. So in her youthfulness, she is barren. Then the last bit says, and will not remember the reproach of your widowhood anymore. So ultimately, God is speaking about taking a shame from the eyes and from the life of a barren woman, and which means that he will eventually bless her, he will eventually make her reproductive, he will eventually make her the mother of nations, he will eventually give her kids that will be reproductive and continue to produce, because it is the will of God for a woman to be reproductive. It is the will of God that a woman should produce. Because the Bible says in Genesis, go into the world and be fruitful. Go into the world and reproduce. Go into the world and multiply. That is the word of God. That is the will of God from the on-go, from the onset. So God is the beginning and God is the end. Now I want to pray that God is able to expand our minds on this word, that God is able to give us more revelational knowledge, that every woman out there who is barren, that the power of God will come upon your life, that the power of God will come and rearrange your womb, will come and give you a womb if you need one, will come and give you a fetus if you need one, will come and give you an uterus if you need one, will come and give you eggs if you need one, and begin to make you fruitful and begin to multiply you from generations to generations. All these I ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. I thank you so much for listening, and God bless. God bless in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.